Chester today, which is on the border between England and Wales, and I'm really happy to be in the home of two NHS doctors. You know, one of the great stories of migration to this country is that of the Indian doctor who trained, born and raised in India, trained in India, and then migrate to this country. In fact, you may not know, but in the 1960s, it was Enoch Powell, who was the Minister for Employment in this country at that time, who was sent to India to recruit doctors because there was a big crisis, a shortage of doctors forecast by the NHS. So he went to India in the early 60s and recruited a large number of doctors who came here, and they were posted to different parts of the country. And in fact, that link and that legacy continues to this day. And that is why one of the greatest professions where Indians have a strong presence in this country is health and the NHS. So I'm very pleased to be with Dr. Rupa Adke. And she's been in this country for 15 years. And as you know, her children have been born here, both of them. And she now lives in Chester and works just across the border in Wales. Coming from India to this country to start a new life, a new career, what was it like? What were your hopes when you came? Were you...
There were a lot of things to adjust for me. Obviously, I was newly married when I came here 15 years ago. I'm definitely very new country. Had to leave my mom, dad back home and brother. So there was some anxiety and missing the family. Also looking to, you know, see new culture and see...
Excitement.
See for the excitement about it as well. So there was a mixed feelings.
Fantastic. And how has the experience been? You've lived here 15 years. You've lived in many different cities in England.
Yes, I have. Yeah. We moved from, we were in London to start with, then Midlands. We lived in Scotland and we are in, you know, closer to Wales. We did live in Wales for some years as well. Mm-hmm. And yes, gradually we have developed, you know, over the years, among socializing is one of the major part, apart from doing the career as well. Mm-hmm. And children, growing up the children as well. Mm-hmm. And initially there was, you know, very small community, you know, we were just making some new friends and things. Mm. Along the way, we did meet lots of people and there were communities. But when we moved into North Wales, there wasn't a much bigger community. Mm. But gradually we have developed our own group associations and we are beginning to do more.
Yeah, I mean, that's something quite amazing about Indian migrants to this country. Because India has got a strong culture of family and community, and the links between family and community, where people have migrated, if there is no community, they've ended up building one community and created a family, a home from home in this way. It's not easy to create a community. It requires a lot of sacrifice. And remember, raising children is itself hard work. I'm sure many of you know this from experience. So bringing up children and at the same time creating a community, making friends and really doing something to keep that cultural identity alive and pass it on to the next generation is an instinct for so many Indians up and down the country. Not in an exclusive way, but in a way which is inclusive, but at the same time that identity is contained. So tell us a little bit about that kind of, you know, raising children in a different country and in a different cultural environment. What have you done to try and give them the Indian values and culture? And
I think it's there are lots of facts involved here. Because we both were working full time, so it's issues of childcare. Mm-hmm. And it's a different culture. The children are brought up in this environment. Obviously, you know, they are going to pick up that one, so we need to understand that and accommodate. And at the same time, making them realize what culture we come from, to be proud of the culture they come from, the roots. So we do kind of, you know, mix with the community we come from as well, and mix with their friends as well. So kind of, you know, getting the balance right.
Mm. So how do you feel? Do you feel that that balance is working? That
balance is working. Obviously, it's not a steady thing. You know, sometimes it does tip up and down, but we come back together.
Mm-hmm. Fantastic. Because it's interesting that we are living in a time where India is looking towards the West very much.
That's right, yes.
And here we are in the living in the West, looking towards the East, you know. What I find, and one of the aims of the Masala Tour is to find this bridge between the East and the West, and this idea where different cultures can coexist and different wisdoms can enrich one another.
Definitely. I think there are a lot more to learn from, you know, British culture as well, you know, for even, for example, the timekeeping, those sort of things,
professionalism.
I have learned from them, and, you know, and they are obviously like our food or, you know, some of the clothes we wear, and we share it both. I think that there is good balance if you get, it's very nice.